Excuse me. I say, I couldn't help noticing you in your store and wondering if you make egg creams.
Yeah, I make egg creams.
The old-fashioned egg cream, which I've been searching high and low, near and far. The kind that just isn't made anymore.
Well, I've been making the same egg cream for the last 25 years.
I don't believe it. Thank goodness we took the wrong turn. I might never have found you. At last, the egg cream of my dreams. I can almost taste it now.
Excuse me for staring at you, but you look sort of kind of familiar. You happen to be James Earl Jones? James Earl Jones, the famous movie star. Mr. Hooper. James Earl Jones in my store. I've seen almost every picture you've made. I'm a great fan of yours.
And I may be a fan of yours.
Yes, yes, yes. well, yeah, no. Here you are. By the way, can I have an autograph of yours? On this paper plate, if you don't mind. There.
Hey, Mr. Pooper, do you know that there's a huge car parked in front of your store?
Mr. Pooper, there's a huge bird parked in your store.
Hooper.
Hi, I'm Big Bird.
You can say that again.
Hi, I'm Big Bird.
Big Bird?
Hmm?
That's the famous movie star, James Earl Jones.
Wow, it is?
Yes.
What's a movie star?
Well,
is that someone who signed his name on paper plates?
No. He's signing his autograph for me. A movie star is someone who's acted in the movies, who's acted in so many movies that he's famous.
You've been
and
in
everybody,
movies?
Yes, everybody knows him.
Really?
That's why I signed the paper plate.
Wow.
Also
thank you.
Egg cream.
Yes. Your egg cream, sure. Mm. Here we are.
He makes nice egg creams.
Straw.
Oh, yours.
No.
Spoon.
Thank you.
You're right.
Mr. Hooper, there's a spick. James Earl Jones! I can't believe it in Mr. Hooper's store. This is amazing. What are you doing here?
Trying to enjoy this egg cream.
You drink egg creams, do you? I don't believe it. He drinks egg creams. I drink egg creams, too. Oh, go right ahead.
Hey, Mr. Hooper, is the big limousine charger? James Earl Jones? Wow. Hey, can I shake your hand? Wow, that's terrific. That must be your limousine parked out in front, is it? Mr. Hooper, this is James Earl Jones,
the
famous
actor.
Oh, I know, he's terrific. I've seen everything. I've seen
everything. Back. Just a touch.
Oh, no.
Wait,
Mr. Jones. The egg cream.
No, I don't understand.
It's gone flat.
Let me make
a fresh one for you. It's been standing around too long.
You don't want to drink a flat egg cream.
I know.
I mean, really.
No. They've got to be fresh. Oh, that's...
Excuse me.
Thank you. And cheers.
Cheers.
Ah.
I think he likes it.
Boil it. Just like I used to drink as a kid.
Wow, look at that.
Oh, he's drinking it.
James Earl Jones in my store.
Wow.
On a cold forest oak sat the crow, with a fine piece of cheese in his beak. Full of joy was the crow with his meal above the snow, as the cold winds blew softly about him, as the cold winds blew softly about him. Like a flame came the fox through the forest, spied the crow with a smile and a bow, said hello. fellow handsome crow. You are beautiful, you know. It's a shame you can't sing to your beauty. It's a shame you can't sing to your beauty. Not the crow, handsome bird that I am. I can sing even more handsomely. From his wide open throat came an ice crackling note.
Macaw!
And the fox jumped and ran with the cheese. And the fox jumped and ran with the cheese.
Ernie, when are you gonna clean up your room, huh? Oh boy.
Let's see, I'm gonna clean it up Tuesday after next, Bert.
Where are you?
I'm over here, Bert. Oh. Can you make it through?
Yeah, I just finally did.
Yeah.
Hey, Ernie.
Yeah, Bert.
It's your turn to go to the laundromat and wash our laundry.
Oh, it is, Bert?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, fine, okay. Sure. I'll got the laundry basket right here, Bert.
You got the laundry basket
yep.
There?
Mm-hmm. I'll see you after
Ernie,
a while, huh?
Hold it, Ernie. Ernie, hold it.
Yeah, Bert?
Come back here.
What is it, Bert?
Put the laundry basket down.
Yeah?
Okay, now you're going to the laundromat, right?
Mm-hmm.
To do the laundry, right?
Yeah, Bert.
With the laundry basket, right?
Sure, Bert.
Well, look closely at the laundry basket and tell me, didn't you forget something, Ernie?
Forget something?
Yes, Ernie, forget something.
By golly, you're right, Bert.
Yeah.
I forgot my rubber ducky. Just a second, I got him right over here somewhere.
Rubber ducky?
Mm-hmm. Where are you? There you are.
Ernie?
There he is. Mm-hmm. Okay, rubber ducky, you ready to go do the laundry? He's ready. Just a second. There you go. All ready for the trip?
Ernie?
Yes, Bert?
Ernie, besides your rubber ducky, you forgot something else.
Something else?
Now, your rubber ducky is nice, but...
Of course! I forgot my storybooks. Rubber ducky likes to hear stories while we do the wash, Bert.
Ernie?
Here you go, rubber ducky. Heads up.
No, Ernie. There's something else.
Oh,
not your rubber ducky, not your storybooks.
Cookies! Sure, right.
Cookies?
We may get hungry. There you go.
No, that's not all. I mean, you forgot the most important thing. You forgot something. Now, what is it?
You're right, my boots, Bert.
Your boots?
Sure, my boots, in case the washing machine overflows.
I don't
want to get my feet wet, Bert.
Oh, boy.
Oh, let's see. Oh, I know. How about my radio? Sure, here's my radio.
Ernie.
There we go.
Ernie.
Nice music, you see? Right. And
Ernie.
I can listen to music, see?
Turn it off, Ernie. Ernie, turn it off.
What, Bert?
I said, turn it off!
Okay, Bert. Here we go.
Ah!
Oh, and how about my ukulele so I can play along with the music, Bert?
There
we go. Don't want to forget my ukulele. Oh, and then there's my yo-yo. Sure. And then,
Ernie,
how about
look.
The basketball?
There's a basketball court down there?
Well, there might be a few of us there waiting around.
Boy.
And then there's my coloring books.
Mm-hmm. Ernie.
And my crayons.
Okay, Ernie! Ernie!
Did I forget something else, Bert?
Yes!
What, Bert?
Ernie?
Yes?
You forgot to put the laundry in the laundry basket.
The laundry!
Right. And now that the basket is so full of junk, you have no room for the laundry.
Oh, you're right, Bert.
Yeah.
And if I can't fit the laundry in, then I won't be able to carry it to the laundromat, huh?
Right.
Oh, and if I can't get the laundry to the laundromat, then I won't be able to do the laundry, Bert.
Right again, Ernie.
Oh, right, Bert.
Yeah, now what are you going to do?
Go play baseball, Bert. I'll see you.
This is the small letter D, and it makes a sound like D. D is the first sound in the word dig. D is also the first sound in the word deep. If you dig deep enough, you may discover a dinosaur down in the ground.
to fix this wagon.
How?
What do you think is wrong with it, Maureen?
Because it's broke.
It's broke and I gotta put the handle on.
Oh.
How should I do that?
Sometimes daddy
fixes
stuff.
Your daddy fixes stuff?
Yep.
How about you? You ever fix anything?
Yes.
What do you fix?
Wagon.
What did you fix?
Wagon. I was helping my dad fixing his.
Now what do we do?
Fix it.
You can tell me about your dad while we fix this. Okay, now. Put the washer on. That's a girl. Nut on. Can you hold this for me, Maureen, please? Thank you. Just start a little bit. Turn it towards you. That's it. Now then I'll turn the screw. I'll turn the bolt this way. You turn the nut the other way. Okay. Turn it towards you. I'll turn it this way. It's feeling tight now?
Yep.
Okay. Here, it will make it even tighter. Yeah. If you can hold this.
Me?
Yeah, you. You,
okay.
You, Maureen, wait. Let me tighten it. Okay, now you hold this so we can make it nice and tight. You got it?
Yep.
All right, now
I got it.
Okay, good. Oh, boy, I don't know what I would do without you two girls helping me. There we go. And you help your daddy?
Yeah,
what
look.
What were you saying?
Look. I was helping my daddy with his
self
for his book.
We did it.
That's nice.
It's fixed. And you know the best thing about fixing toys?
Yep.
What's the best thing?
But sometimes daddy fixes toys every day.
And when he fixes them, what do you do with it?
Play with it.
Play with it.
Say?
Roof.
The doggy. Very good, Jason.
Say, that's a beautiful D you're building there.
Sure is, isn't it? Look at that nice straight back. And how about this curved front here, huh? Fits perfectly to the back. Okay, boys, take it away.
What are you going to do with this D?
Why, this is the D building here. It's full of everything in the world that begins with the letter D. Here, this floor here is the doll floor. They've already moved some dolls in, I see.
Yes, doll begins with D, doesn't it?
And here's the dog floor. Boy, listen to him bark. D-O-G spells dog, all right.
And this must be the floor with diamonds. Aren't they beautiful?
Wow. Hold your ears. Here's the drum floor.
Drum begins with D, too.
And here's where the ducks and dinosaurs and desks will be, on these floors here. Here we are.
Wait, I know a word that begins with D that you forgot to put in your building.
Downtown disco, all the ladders strut their stuff. Be it beat from doing the buster, but you never get enough.
Woo! You dance from dawn to dinner, and when they close the door at 3, you still see ducks and dolls and going out dancing with the disco D.
Disco D.
Disco D. Disco D. Dancing all the day.
At the downtown disco dancing till they start to drop. He gets pooped from doing the hustle, but you never seem to stop.
Woo! You dance from dawn to dinner, and when they close the door at 3, you still see ditches, dogs, and daisies dancing with the disco D.
Disco D.
Disco D. Disco D. Dancing all the day.
A shape, and then I'll ask you to identify the shape. Okay, now open your eyes. Can you tell me what this shape is?
Triangle.
Triangle. Great. Boy, you didn't have any trouble with that at all. Yeah, now I'm gonna get another. Close your eyes. Okay. Now, can you tell me what this shape is?
Square.
A square. Yeah, it's got four corners all the same, and four sides all the same size. That's great. You really do know your shapes, don't you? I got a toughie coming up. Close your eyes. Now, okay, can you tell me what this shape is?
Circle.
A circle. That's right. It's round. Yep, a circle. Great. Boy, you really learned your shapes good. I got one more. Ready? Okay. Here it is. Can you tell me what this shape is?
Rectangle.
A rectangle. Right. Gee whiz. You really know your shapes good, Kim. Thank you. Could I give you a hug? Oh, thank you for helping me.
Give me a D.
D, 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 D.
Give me an O.
O, 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 O.
Give me a G.
G, 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 G.
What do you got? Dog.
Yay! Dog! Rah, rah, rah.
Why, what's the matter, little five?
I think I'm lost.
Well, how did that happen?
I came to the park with my big brother, and I started playing on the swings. And then I couldn't find him anywhere.
Maybe he's playing ball with those big boys over there. Say, fellas, would you come over here a moment, please?
Hi, what's up?
Is this your brother?
No, that's not him. My brother looks just like me, only bigger.
How about him?
Nope.
This him?
No.
Him?
No.
Here's another.
That's not him. Fred!
Hi, Frankie. Where you been?
It's very nice of you to give me a job helping you, Count. What would you like me to do?
I want you to answer my telephone so I don't have to be bothered while I look for things to count.
Answer the telephone, huh? Is that all?
That's enough. It's not as easy as it seems.
Not easy, huh? Well, listen, you can count on me, Count.
Now, what can I find to count? One! One ring!
That's a telephone. I'll answer it.
No, I must count them. Yeah, two. Two rings.
I have to answer the phone there.
No, I am counting the rings. Three rings.
I'll get it.
Oh, you tricky Ernie. No, four rings.
But I have to answer the...
Five.
Hello? Hello?
Five glorious rings.
Hello? 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 They hung up.
Of course, you took so long to answer.
But you wouldn't let me answer it.
I told you, it wouldn't be easy. Ah, they're calling back.
I'll get it.
One ring. No, I'm counting.
I'll get it, too.
Two rings.
Oh. Hello? I'll get the phone. Just a minute. Coming. In a second. Hold on there. I'll get it.
See you later on.
Okay, have a good day.
You too.
that I can cry. I feel lonely and yet I don't know why. I feel very small in a world that's wide.
It's time for your favorite show, Here Is Your Life. And here is your life host, Guy Smiley.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Here Is Your Life. I'm Guy Smiley, and as you can see, I am disguised as a dentist in order to greet our next guest. Oh, here he comes now. Shh, don't give away our little surprise.
Hello, doctor. Wait. I don't know you.
You certainly do, because I'm Guy Smiley! And Tooth, here is your life!
Oh, no! Yes! What a surprise!
Yes!
How wonderful! For a moment, I thought you were a meter maid.
Tooth!
Yes?
Yours has been a full and active life. Several years ago, you replaced your little brother, Baby Tooth.
Yes, he went to live with the Tooth Fairy.
Yes, and you were small at first, too. But you quickly learned to eat and chew good things.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see if you recognize these sounds.
Why, that's... Of course, those are my friends, Vegetable and Milk.
That's right! And representing the vegetables, we have Carl Carrot and your other friend, Melvin Milk.
Oh, no.
Yes!
Carl, Melvin.
Hi, Ed. Hi. Oh, boy, I remember you so well. He chewed all his vegetables and got the exercise he needed.
Yeah, and I still help him stay healthy and strong.
I don't know what I'd have done without them, Guy. See you later, guys.
See ya.
Oh, God.
But, Tooth, your life hasn't always been so happy, has it?
Well, no.
There was a time when you chewed too many of those other things.
It's true. Too many lollipops and gooey candy bars.
Until you found that a small hole was beginning in you.
Yes, a cavity. And did it hurt?
But just then, someone came along to help you. Do you recognize this voice?
Open wide, please.
No, it can't be.
But it is. The friendly dentist who took care of you and has made sure you've stayed healthy ever since.
Oh, doctor.
And better still, the dentist introduced you to two of your best friends, Toothbrush and Toothpaste.
Bristly and pasty. Oh, I wouldn't be what I am today if it weren't for you two.
Yes, Tooth?
Yes?
There it is.
Where?
And we're glad to have you and all your friends together on... Here is Your Life!
Oh.
One, two, three, four, five. 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 One, two, three, four, five. 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 One, two, three, four, five. Five. One, two, three, four, five. Five. M.
Hey, what animal has the very longest neck? What's the tallest animal? Not frogs. How about a giraffe?
Giraffe has long neck.
Long yeah, a giraffe neck. Has a very long neck, doesn't it?
Yeah, froggy. Yeah.
Dinner's ready.
Okay, Bert, I'll be right along. Okay. Right after I have a couple of these cookies.
Hey, no, you ding-a-ling. No, you don't eat cookies before dinner. You eat them after dinner. They might spoil your appetite.
Right, Bert.
Okay.
I'll be right along right after I have a couple of these cookies.
Good. Hey, no, wait a minute now. Hey, Ernie, don't you know the difference between before and after?
Oh, sure, Bert. Yeah, I just, I'm not so sure.
Yeah. Okay, well, now listen carefully, and I'll try and explain it to you, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, you see, before you can have those cookies, you have to lift that cover.
Uh-huh.
Right. Now, after the cover is lifted, then you can have the cookies.
Right.
Right. Now you understand?
Well, let me see now. Make sure I understand it. Now, before I can have a cookie,
yeah?
I have to lift the cover.
Right.
Now, after I lift the cover, then I can have a cookie.
Right. Okay, now, let's go to dinner, okay?
No. I'm not sure that I got it absolutely straight. Now, see if this is right.
Yeah.
Now, before I can have a cookie,
yeah.
I have to lift the cover.
Right.
Now, then, after I lift the cover,
yeah.
Then I can have a cookie.
Okay, right. Now you know it, so let's go.
One more time. One more time, just to make sure, absolutely certain I got it right.
All right.
Now, before I can have a cookie, I have to lift the cover.
Lift the cover.
After the cover is lifted, then I can have the fourth cookie.
Right. Okay, now you understand, so let's go and eat, all right?
Eat?
Yeah.
Gee, Bert, I'm not hungry now. You want a cookie, Bert?
Before.
I think I hear someone knocking at my door. I wonder who that can be on a terrible cold night like it is tonight. Why, Grover!
Oh, Froggy! I'm so glad you are here! Froggy, I need your help.
Oh, what can I do for you, Grover?
Froggy, I'm so cold! Would you please tell me how to get warm?
Well, Grover, come inside!
But I... Okay. Okay, now... Now, Froggy, Froggy, I am inside now. Now, will you please tell me how to get warm?
How to get warm?
Yes, but wait,
look here.
Wait, I know. In order to get warm, you could run around and jump up and down, couldn't you?
Well,
yes, that will get you warm, of course. Thank you very much, Froggy.
Yeah, but,
Okay. Running up and down and jumping, here we go. If you do this long enough, if you really exercise and run around and jump up and down, you will soon get very, very tired. And I am still cold all over my body.
Why, Grover?
Oh, Froggy. It did not work. Please tell me how to get warm.
Grover, come inside.
But, oh, all right, Froggy. Okay, I'm inside again. But now will you please tell me how to get warm?
But, Grover, don't you understand?
Oh, wait. Of course I understand, Froggy. Your earmuffs over there. I will put your earmuffs on. That will get me warm.
Yeah, but Grover, you don't really get the whole picture.
Wait,
you see?
Froggy, I can't talk now. I can't even hear you. I got earmuffs on.
Yeah, but...
Okay. These earmuffs should keep my ears nice and toasty warm. My ears are nice and toasty warm. Mm-hmm. But the rest of me is freezing!
Hi there, Grover.
Oh, Kermit, please help me.
Yeah, but...
I cannot get warm. Please tell me how to get warm.
Grover,
please help me.
Grover, come inside.
Why?
Because it's warm inside, Grover. Inside is warm, you see? Outside is cold. If you want to get warm, you come inside where it's warm.
Wait.
If you stay outside, you'll stay cold.
Wait, Froggy, let me get this straight.
Oh.
Do you mean to tell me, is this frog to monster telling me that if I... Little Grover, go inside.
Yeah.
I will be warm.
Mm-hmm.
And if we go outside,
yeah,
we are cold then in the snow.
It's freezing out here.
Is that what you tried to tell me?
Yes, it certainly is.
So the
You're
answer,
getting a picture, Grover.
The answer is for the monster to go inside.
Right, Grover.
It will be warm.
Now you got it, Grover.
Oh, Froggy, thank you very much.
Oh, you're.
Yes, that is right. I am feeling warmer already. I think I will just take a little nap. Oh, so toasty warm I feel.
Antes.
Kim?
Yeah.
Look, can you read?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, can you read this sign here?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? Do you know what it says?
Closed.
Yeah? Well, what does it mean?
It means closed.
Ooh. Wow. You ask a rotten question, you get a rotten answer.
B. A little brown boy in a blue robe and his baby bear Bosco always take a bath together, and together they make bubbles, bubbles, and more bubbles.
Take a breath, smell the smell, sniff a sniff, take a breath. You can move your feet to walk, and you use your tongue to talk, but your mouth and nose are waiting. Take a breath, take a breath, take a breath. Smell a smell, sniff a sniff, take a breath. You can move your teeth to chew, but your face is turning blue. Get some air inside of you, just take a breath. You never think of breathing, though you do it all day long. You even have to breathe to sing this funny little song. You've got to take a breath before you try to blow a bubble. And if you stop your breathing, you got big, big trouble. So take a good deep breath. That's better. Take a breath. Take a breath. Smell a smell, sniff a sniff, and take a breath. There are many ways to play, but you're growing every day, and you need some ventilation. Take a breath. You got to do your breathing. Take a breath. Take a breath.
Here we see Big Daniel Boone. See the bear prints? Daniel Boone is bravely tracking a bear.
Here,
these bear prints were obviously made by a very big bear.
Bear prints? Sure is a big one.
Uh-oh.
Here, Buyer. Buyer, where are ya?
High today of 65, there's a 50% chance of rain, so if you're going out, you might want to take along your umbrella. And now back with...
Hey, Bert, did you hear that? See, I'm going to the library, Bert, and I think I better take along an umbrella, just like the guy said. Well, you see, you know, if it rains, like the man said it may, I gotta be all prepared for it, because I am planning for the rain, and so that's why I take along an umbrella. But hey, Bert, you know, if we have a huge rainstorm, Bert, if we have a huge rainstorm, this umbrella won't be enough. You know, and I think if we have a huge rainstorm, I don't want to be unprepared.
What? Ernie!
Here, see, Bert? Now I've got my rain hat and my raincoat and my galoshes on, Bert, and my umbrella, so I am certainly ready for a very heavy rain. Because if it rains and rains and rains and rains, well, then we're going to have water. Hey, Bert, then we're going to have water all over the place. And, Bert, you know, we might even have a flood. And if I get stuck at the library during the flood, well, then I'll need food. Food, Bert. Just a second, Bert. I'll be right back.
What flood?
See, what I'll need is some milk and some bread and peanut butter.
Will you take this umbrella off my book? It's right in the middle of a sentence.
Apples, ice cream, should
do it. What is going on?
Now, see, I certainly have the food, so I'm not going to starve at the library during the flood, Bert.
Ernie, what flood?
I certainly know how to prepare for a flood.
Ernie, it is not even raining out.
Yes, but it might, Bert. It just might. And if it does, Bert, if it does rain and rain and rain, then I'm going to be stuck at the library during the flood, and I will be all prepared for it.
Ernie, you are not going to get stranded in the library, believe me.
You're right, Bert. I'm not going to get stranded in the library. I might get stranded outside of the library on my way to the library. Here, Bert, hold this.
Will you please stop?
Just a second, Bert. I'll be right back.
Take this umbrella off my foot,
Bert.
I don't want to hold this. Oh, there goes the umbrella. There goes, of course.
Now, here we go, Bert.
Are there eggs in here?
Here's what I need.
What's going on?
See there, Bert? It's a life preserver, Bert. If I'm stranded outside during the flood, you see.
Ernie, you have gone bananas.
No, Bert. I've got my rain hat and my raincoat and my umbrella, Bert, and my galoshes and
Wonderful.
My food, and I have everything but...
Fine, get out of here.
Bert!
Get everything. Leave me alone.
Bert!
What?
How could I forget you, Bert?
You didn't. You put groceries
on me. I don't
want
to get stuck out there without my best friend. What are friends for, Bert? Come on, Bert.
What do you
mean,
gotta
go to the library with me.
What are you doing?
We've all got to be here when the flood comes.
I got to read
come
my
on,
book.
Bert.
I just want some peace and
here,
quiet.
Can you open the door, Bert?
Wait a minute, open the door?
Here we go. All right.
Ernie,
come on. Here we
go. Careful with that umbrella.
Oh, it's going to be
Ernie.
So much fun, Bert.
What do you mean, fun? All I want is a little peace and quiet. Ernie, come on, please. You dropped the preserver. You dropped the egg.
Boy, oh boy, I met a famous movie star today. And he was really nice, too. Gosh, must be fun to be famous. Riding around in a big, long, long car like that. And not only that, you get to wear sunglasses all the time, even if it's raining. Gee, I'd sure like to be a movie star. I have sunglasses. I could get those out and I could pretend I was a movie star. That would be fun to do. Hey, let's see. Saw them just a little while ago. Let's see. Here they are. Mm-hmm. Boy, listen, if I got sunglasses, I can easily be a movie star. Why, what else would a person need? Well, maybe a tie, something else. Oh, boy, this is going to be fun.
Yes, yes, right here in my store. James Earl Jones, the famous movie star. I know you'll like him. He was sitting on a first stool, and he had a neck cream, and he said he liked it very much. Yes, yes, yes. Well, I don't know. I don't know what to tell you. No, don't come in for Chicago. But let me tell you something. I'm going to have now what is called a special egg cream called a James Earl Jones egg cream.
You should never wash this, Mr. Hooper.
Never. Yes, yes. I know you like him very much. Well, goodbye. That was my aunt in Chicago, and she loves James Earl Jones. She thinks he's the greatest.
Who doesn't?
He's you know.
A, that's the first movie star I've ever met.
Actor, actor.
Yeah, right. Carl. Hey, hi, Big Bird.
Big
Hello there.
Bird. In my store, Big Bird.
Yes, the movie star.
Yes, yes.
No, you know me as a movie star, of course.
Sure.
After all, you Big probably Bird. Recognize me since I've made so many flicks.
Yes, of course.
You do me a big favor, Big Bird?
Mm-hmm.
Give me your autograph.
Oh, sure. Take anything you like.
No. Just your autograph.
What's that?
That's sign my paper plate.
Your name.
Oh,
your
sure.
Name.
Here, hold my glove.
Hey, you are.
Big Bird's glove.
Big gloves.
Look at that. He's signing the paper plate.
It has to be a star.
Oh, boy, look at it. Oh, that's good. Oh, thank you. Mr. Big
welcome.
Bird.
It's nothing much, but say, listen, I have a very busy schedule, you know, so... I better get in my car and head on down.
We'll get the door for you, Big Bird.
Let me help you, Big Bird. Yes. Come on, Big Bird. Let's go. Here you are, Big Bird.
There we go.
Big Bird.
Right this way, Mr. Big Bird.
Come on, Big
Star, Big Bird.
Here we are.
Your car is wet.
Wow. We sure are pretending real.
Excuse me, but this may sound simply crazy, but that egg cream was so delicious, I simply must have another one, and this one to go.
Did you hear me? He wants another one to go.
To go.
Gee, well, there's a lot to be said for pretending. Okay, driver, let's go.
This is the small letter B, and it makes a sound like B. B is the first sound in the word bat. B is also the first sound in the word ball.
Anybody want to play baseball?
B is also the first sound in the word break.
Is your egg cream to go? Thank you very much.
Thank you. Farewell.
Bye-bye.
Farewell.
Come back for another egg cream.
Oh. Bye, Mr. Jones.
Goodbye, Mr. Jones.
May the force be with you.
Farewell.
Come back.
Come back again.
Bye. Sorry, Bob.
Goodbye.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters B and D and by the silly number 5.
production of the Children's Television Workshop.